What is going on YouTube? It's Corgi Kong here, and today I'm going to show you how to make a mob trap. This is basically what it will look like. And so let's get started. And we are back. Okay, I'm sure you cannot see, so let me just brighten this up a little bit. I put it on peaceful so I can just show you the video. Basically, when you find a mob spawner, you're going to just put the torches around it and then destroy the spawner. Well, why destroy what can be turned into treasure? All you have to do is make a way so that when they spawn, you get loot and they die. I don't mind the glass. I just put it there for viewing purposes after I make the video. So basically, first thing you're going to do is go right off to one side. It could be any side of the spawner. So I chose this side, and you're going to dig two blocks down in a straight line. Like so. And you're going to dig it 8 blocks long. 8 blocks long is the length of the flow of water. When you put a water current down, it'll go from here all the way to here and then stop. And in Minecraft, mobs have a very hard time fighting current because they have no backbone or strength. So, we're just going to dig this whole thing out. I chose a skeleton spawner because I like the bones and the arrows the most. I actually use it more than feathers or gunpowder from zombies and creepers. I'll be making a video on how to do all sorts of mobs, such as spiders. It's a little bit more challenging because you need lava, but it works pretty well. Now that we have it, 4 or 5 blocks wide, the length of the width of the dungeon, we are going to put water in these blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I clogged it up so that we can continue working without any trouble. And now what you're going to do is you're going to come to the 9th block. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is the 9th. Oh yeah, okay, I remember. Gotcha. This is the 9th. Now let's clog this back up. That was a mistake. Okay, so we're gonna dig down. Oh, that was some Blorp Cola, by the way. Dropped by the none other than Blorps themselves. You're gonna dig this, the 9th block, 3 blocks down. 3 blocks down, because it has to be 1 block of room for the skeleton to just fall, so that if it's on the water on the 2nd block, it cannot jump back up, and the 2nd block so that it can't jump back up, and it's 2 blocks high, which is enough to drown a skeleton, zombie, or creeper. Next thing we're going to do is just dig this out. Anywhere from 3 to 8 blocks is all up to you. And this was already cleared out from before, from the intro you saw. I just didn't want to clog that back up. So you're gonna go the whole length. Get rid of all this, these blocks. And now, this is what I like to do. I like to put stone slabs a couple blocks away from where they die and drown. And I gotta get rid of this. So you have headroom to go and actually collect the loot. Okay. Cool. Now I want to take glass. I like glass because you can actually see them drowning and point and laugh and make fun of them. And you'll know when they die and when they're about to die. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take the water. Oh, and if you are doing this legit without modding, here's what you do. You get two buckets of water. Oops. Two buckets of water and make a 4x4 square. I suggest making it over on this side after the blocks. And put one in the corner, put the other block in the corner. And now you have an infinite water source. No matter where you take it from, it will just refill. Yeah. Okay. Now what we're going to do, and you just do this. You put water on the second block. On the second block, and you come back, grab some more. And you come back. And put on the second block of all the blocks. And then when you have it all the way down, just clog up the last piece of glass, and you're set. You have done this portion. Now what you can do is that we're going to go all the way back. And this time, we're all the way over here. We are going to get rid of this row of blocks. Now here's what will happen when the zombies go down. When the skeletons go down. They will eventually walk around and fall down here. And they can try all they want, but they will not make it back up. And as soon as they get here, okay, look, I'm going to let go of the keyboard, but hold the flying, put on my flying mod, so that you can actually see where I stopped. I stop outside of this block. I don't stop on it. I actually stop off of it. And this lets the skeletons fall down, and they will try to jump and everything. But eventually, they stop and they'll drown and take damage. When it gets really filled up, like you saw in the introduction, if not more, they'll go on top of each other and they won't be able to jump and they'll just drown faster. Which is why I like to put on hard when I'm trying to collect more resources, because they spawn more. I think they spawn more. Okay, now I'm going to show you how it actually works. Let's get rid of all these torches. Let's put it on hard. And let's watch them spawn. You see, they're spawning, and they immediately fall down over here. As you can see, we can see the skeletons, and they're trapped in there. This one's underneath the water, but you see, as I told you before, that one's jumping above it. Eventually, it will stop jumping and go back down. Now, we're going to watch this one, because I think it's going to take damage soon. See? But then it goes up. When it takes damage, it starts to go back up. But if there are more skeletons, it won't be able to go back up because it is trapped. Okay, that skeleton just spawned, and it's walking around, and it just walked off like a dummy. Now we're going to go to the collection point. And collect some loot. You can hear one dying right now. That was going to die. And it died. And the loot just goes underneath and flows to the bottom where we can pick it up. Like I said, this only works with creepers, zombies, and skeletons. It will not, I repeat, it will not work with spiders. Spiders are 2 blocks long, and they will not fit down that hole. They're, I believe, 2x2. These are 1x2. No, skeletons are 2x2x2 or 2x2x1. I don't know. But either way, they will not fit through the hole. Only skeletons, creepers, and zombies can, because their dimensions are 2 blocks by 1 block. 1 block wide and 2x1x1. So 1 block wide, 1 block long, 2 blocks high. I have a lava trap for everything. All mobs. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Please leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Peace.